Ciao friends! I want to show how to create your first calculation group in Power BI Desktop using Tabular Editor. The Time Intelligence is a good example for the calculation group. Time Intelligence are calculations that apply transformations to existing measures, creating new measures. For example, in this report, I have the sales amount, then I have the previous year, the difference between the current year and the previous year, and the difference as a percentage. But this is only for sales amount. And in order to do that, I have now one measure for each value I want to display in my model. Now, if I want to apply the same transformations to other measures, I need to define calculation items in calculation group that have this logic. Now, in order to do that, I need a tool that enables me to modify and to create the entities in the tabular model, because Power BI Desktop has a tabular model inside but doesn't have an editor to modify all the properties of this model. Tabular Editor can do just that. So download the Tabular Editor, install Tabular Editor, and once you do that, you see that you have in this external tools ribbon in Power BI Desktop an icon with Tabular Editor. When you click on this icon, you open a window with the access to the model, to the tabular model of Power BI. And because this could be a dangerous operation, you have a warning that tells you, be careful, create a backup of your PBX file before doing this. You never know. You have to be careful because not all the properties are supported by Power BI Desktop, but calculation group is safe to use, so we can create and modify calculation groups through Tabular Editor. Now, Tabular Editor gives me access to all the entities, tables, measures, columns of my model. For example, you see here that in sales I have several measures and I can see the code of each measure here. And Tabular Editor is a wonderful editor for these properties. But what we want to do, we want to create a calculation group. And the calculation group, from the point of view of the tabular model, is a special kind of a table. And in order to create a calculation group, we can go here and create the new calculation group. The calculation group we want to create must have a name. We want to call it Time Intelligence. And the calculation group is a special kind of table that has only two columns. One is visible and the other is invisible just for the sort order. The default name is Name. I prefer to call it Formula. So let me rename it Formula. And you see that this is a special kind of table because under Time Intelligence I have a special folder called Calculation Items. This table is populated by the information we provide in this editor, and I can create one or more calculation items. Usually you create two or more calculation items. And each calculation item has a name, and this is the name that will be provided as a value in the special column we created in this table. So the names we want to create are the names of the transformations for the Time Intelligence calculation. So we want to create the previous year, year over year, and year over year as a percentage. So let me create these names. I just use acronyms. So PY for the previous year, then I right click and I create YOY for year over year, and the same for a percentage. So far, so good. Now I have a table that has one column and three values in this column. But I still have to create what is the behavior of the calculation item. Otherwise, this would create a calculation error if I don't provide a DAX expression here. So each calculation item has a DAX expression that replaces the measure that you have in the report when you apply this calculation item. So what we want to do for the previous year? Well, we want to get the value of the current measure in the current filter context, and we want to translate this measure into the past, into the same period in the previous year. So we want to actually compute the existing measure in a different filter context, shifting the date using the same Time Intelligence calculation we also have in our measure, sales PY. So what I can do, the easiest way to start is to get an existing calculation like sales PY and paste this code here. But I have to make a change here. I don't want to compute sales amount all the times. If sales amount is the measure applied to the report, I want to do this. but if the measure applied to the report is margin or total cost, I want to use that measure. So I can use a special function that is sort of as a sort of a placeholder for the current measure that you have in the report. And this special function is called selected measure. Now, by doing this, this is a generic calculation that can be applied on any measure. I do the same for the year over year. And the easiest way is to go here and copy the code I have here. Now, this code is just something more than just doing the difference between the current value and the value of the previous year, because we want to make sure to display the value only if both the current value and the previous year value are available. So we don't want to display, for example, values in the future. And again, here, sales amount is something that I can replace with my selected measure special function. But for previous year, I have to use the expression I used for my PY calculation item definition. Technically, I could invoke another calculation item of the same calculation groups, but this is something we suggest you not to do. So this is called sideways recursion. There are problems in using this technique. You have to be careful about many things. This is described in articles about calculation groups we published. So I simply prefer not to use it, and I just copy and paste the code to compute the value for the previous period. Now I have here references only to selected measure. I'm not referencing any measure directly. So this is a generic code that can be applied in any part of my report. And finally, what about the calculation of the percentage? If you see, the original measure is this divide, but when I go here, once again, I have the problem of the sideways recursion that I want to avoid, so I can just get this code. And I can use this code here. So this is not result, but this is a value YOY. And I use this here. So the final result of my calculation item will be this divide. But the sales PY is my value previous period. So you see that using variables usually is relatively easy to obtain the calculation we want. In any case, you can see that I just copied the same code that we had before, and I obtained the calculation, the calculation of the percentage that I want. Now I have my calculation group with the calculation item, but so far I only worked in a copy of this model in Tabular Editor. I didn't apply these changes to Power BI Desktop so far. In order to do that, you go here and you save. You commit your changes. Now, Power BI Desktop has a warning, a yellow warning, that is requiring you to do a refresh. Now, this refresh doesn't refresh the entire model. This refresh refreshes only the table that has been created in the model. A calculation group is a table, and a new table has to be refreshed. Every time you add or remove calculation items in your calculation group, you will see the same warning. Whereas when you just modify the DAX code of a calculation item, you will not see any warning. So I just do this refresh once. And now you see that my model has here a table called time intelligence and a column called formula. What can I do now? Well, let me duplicate this page and let's remove here all the measures. We just keep a sales amount, and I get my formula column of the time intelligence calculation group, and I move this formula here, this column here, in the columns of the matrix. Now every calculation item becomes a column in my report. You see that I have PY, YOY, YOY percentage. So I have applied these changes to sales amount, because in this case, sales amount is the measure that I applied to this matrix. But what happens if now I include also margin? You see that now if we have the previous year computed for the sales amount and the margin measures. So this automatically extends to any measure of the model. However, let me go back to the sales amount. If you remember, let's go back to the original page. In the original page, I had this initial column, which is just the value of the sales amount. How can I see the original value of sales amount? Because my calculation items always do a replacement and show me something different. So what I want to do is probably having a special calculation item that doesn't do anything, just to provide me the original value of the measure. And I could call this current. So I go back here to calculation items and I create current. Now pay attention, now this property ordinal is -1 for every calculation item here. Keep in mind, we will see why I'm showing you this later. So now I save this, and when I go back to time intelligence, that you have this yellow warning, I refresh. So now that I refresh and I go back here, oh, we have an error here, provide a calculation, oh, right. I made a mistake, and this is good, so we can see what happens if I make a mistake. I created the calculation item, I forgot to write the expression index. And when you have a calculation item that is empty, this is what happens. You have an error saying there is a missing expression somewhere, in this case in the calculation item. So let me go back to my tabular editor, go to current, we just have to write selected measure. I save. And I go back to Power BI Desktop, and it just works. As you see, the error disappeared. I didn't receive a yellow warning because I didn't create a new calculation item. In this case, I just modified the DAX expression of an existing calculation item. And now I have a current, PY, YOY, YOY percentage. Now, wait a minute, why current is the first one? Just because I'm lucky, because the alphabetical sort order corresponds to the order that I wanted. But what if I want, for some reason, I want to display previous year at the end here. So I want to get a different sort order. Well, I can obtain a sort order by just moving these names here in calculation items. So for example, I want to get the current first, then I want to get this last, so YOY and YOY percentage in the middle. At this point, Tabular Editor automatically modify the ordinal property of each calculation item in order to make sure that they are sorted in a sequential way according to the sort order you applied here. And this is the sort order we will have in Power BI Desktop too. So if I save this and I go back to Power BI Desktop, you see that I have a refresh required now because the content of the table changed. But now I have current, YOY, YOY percentage, and PY. And this is exactly what I wanted, so I can control the sort order of my calculation items in my calculation group. One last thing is, what about the format? Because so far I see current, YOY, and PY that are displayed with the same format string of the original measured sales amount in this case. But what about this column, year over year percentage? I would expect this to be a percentage. 0, 10 should be 10%. How can I change this? Well, I can, I just have a refresh now required, I don't know why. This is probably a mistake, I don't know what happened, but let's move forward. So at this point, I want to change the format string here. And so we can, for a single calculation item, we can change the format string. And let's fix the percentage here, the format here. The format we want to display is a percentage. And the format string expression can overwrite the original format string expression of the measure. And here we can write any dynamic DAX expression, even though in this case we just needed to write always a constant expression like this. The percent is a string, so you have to use the double quotes to delimit the string, and then you write in this string the format string for the percentage. In this case we want 2 decimal points for the percent, for the percentage to display. So I save this, I go back here, and now I have the year-over-year percentage displayed here. So as you have seen, calculation groups are powerful, but require a different editor outside of Power BI Desktop, and Tabular Editor is a wonderful editor to also maintain measures, transform other properties in a very, very productive way. And I suggest you to read the articles about calculation groups on SQL BI, because the reality is that you need to understand what you can do with calculation groups and what happens when you have multiple calculation groups in your model, where you have dependencies between calculation groups or between calculation items of the same calculation groups. Because as anything, it is very powerful, but you have to understand what are the consequences of changes you apply to the model when you use calculation groups. But this is very, very powerful and will save you a lot of time. So I think that the time you will spend studying calculation groups is time well spent. Enjoy calculation groups, enjoy DAX.